Good morning, how's everyone doing? Well, it is not the best of times for Honest Abe here. If you've been following, you know I just put new tires on. Well, I've put, probably close to 100 miles on them, right? And look at this, bulge. Oh no. So I'll see, maybe Mastercraft will help me out with a warranty replacement on that one. But while that is bad, that's nowhere near the real problem. Look what happened on my drive home yesterday. And don't worry, I think this is legit. Oops, we need the keys. Where were we? Oh yeah. Check this out. Let's close the door so we can all see this. Maybe if we put this right like that, that'll help. No, that is our low oil light. Are we really low on oil? I don't know. I don't hear any lifter clicking or clacking or... I mean, if we were really low on oil, I would think we would hear something. So, my plan is to... Yeah, I don't hear anything. My plan is to change the oil. Now you do hear the water pump pulley making some noise, but other than that, it seems like it's okay. So I'm gonna change the oil right now, see if that helps at all. And then right down here, you can see our oil pressure sending unit or switch. I might change that too. I think that's just failed. But either way, I'm a little bit nervous. So first step, change the oil. That this is just a switch issue. That combined with the fact that I don't actually hear my lifters. But we'll play it safe. We're gonna go ahead and change the oil. Can never hurt anyhow. And we'll order a new switch. All right, now it's the time we get to see what this oil looks like. I suspect it's really watered down. It kind of, you know, when I check it, it's real black, real dirty, and I don't think it really should be. I've only maybe put 2,000 miles on this car since I put this oil in, and it's full synthetic with a good filter, but I don't know. Either way, we're gonna go ahead and drain the oil, put some fresh oil. I suspect we're gonna get pieces of our valve, what do they call them, the umbrellas or whatever, the seal that sits on top of the valve. That when I was redoing the valve covers, there were those things were in pieces up there. So I'm guessing some of those pieces have worked their way all the way down to the oil pan. All right, I bet this is gonna be very watery, drip everywhere. We probably should be wearing some gloves, so we're just gonna do this anyways. Also, when you get a low oil pressure idiot light, probably shouldn't rev the engine up. I know that's what we did, but you know, don't do the same thing. All right, well, there we go. Oil's coming out. Didn't get a whole lot on my hands. That's not too bad. But you can see it's real dirty. It's like pitch black. I don't understand why it would look this way with only 2,000 miles. Unless we're getting maybe some fuel contamination in the oil. All right, we drained all our oil out. We filled our new filter. We also made sure to get the gasket nice and wet on our new filter. You never want to put them out. Oops. Well, I hadn't really spilled any until then. Spilled brand new oil. PL3001, Purolator 1. Is this the wrong filter? Probably. Nope, it's the right one. That's good. The one that I bought at the auto parts store ended up being the wrong one. Luckily, I had a bunch of these laying around. You never want to get rid of your old... Not old. You never want to get rid of filters that you can buy when you're buying oil and it's on sale and it comes with a free filter. Alright, so that's all good. Here, I'll show you guys the oil that came out of the car. It really doesn't look bad. Other than it being, like, very dark. Which I believe is soot and contamination, which... Realistically, the oil... When I had the valve covers off, it was filthy, really like sludgy and old, and then that was probably all conventional oil. I put full synthetic in, which has, you know, a lot of detergents and whatnot. I'm sure it cleaned a lot of that crap out. Oh. Hmm. Our little plug isn't going in very good. Huh. It's the type of thing you never want to force, but... There it goes. And we'll go ahead and tighten that up. We'll put some fresh oil in. While I'm down here, I want to tighten up the bottom alternator bolt. For those of you that aren't familiar with these, that's how you access the bottom bolt, which if you only tighten the one bolt, it still does slide loose over time. And I just have been retightening it every so often because I didn't feel like getting under here. But now that I'm down here, let's kill two birds with one stone. All right, so it's all tight. Here. Here's what I'm talking about with the alternator. Give you guys an idea. You see that that bottom bolt right there on the left? That's a through bolt and there's a nut in the back that you can't get to it from up top. So you gotta get to it from down here to tighten that all the way. So I'm gonna go ahead and stick a pry bar inside there and tighten up my alternator. Well, here's the oil that came out. I don't see anything to be too concerned about other than it's just very, very dark. What do they say in that John Carpenter movie? Nothing but trouble. Wait, is it nothing but trouble? Oh, no, Big Trouble in Little China. With black blood of the earth right there. But yeah. Alright, so nothing. That makes me feel better. I would have been real concerned if I saw some shiny metal in there. And while I was tightening that bottom alternator bolt, I noticed something else. Look at that. There used to be two belts for that alternator. Now there is one belt. I don't know what happened there, but let's fire this up, see how this works out. I disconnected the battery to work on the alternator. Alright, you heard it start from the engine side. Let's take a look on the interior. See how that oil light is coming and going? Either this does have a legitimate oil pressure issue, or the sending unit is bad. So, see how it's kind of flickering? That makes me think it's a sending unit. Yeah, I would think if we had an oil pressure issue, we would hear something. Good news is our new oil pressure switch has arrived, so I'm going to take our old one out. There it is. Pop the new one in and see if we still have a low oil pressure indication. My money is that we will, but we'll find out. In the spirit of working smarter, not harder, I decided to just get some sockets that would fit this. So the new one, pro tip, is an 1 1/16 socket. The original one, it's a 1 inch socket. So the new one is bigger, so it must be better. All right, new switch is installed. Now the moment of truth. Drum roll. Holy crap. That might have fixed it. Yay! You definitely do not have an oil pressure light anymore. So all along, it may have actually just been a bad switch. Oh, that's awesome news. Yes. Well, in that case, I need to get a hold of Mastercraft and get myself a new, hopefully, a new warranty replacement rear tire because of this little sucker here. A little bit of a bulge in the sidewall. What happened there, Mastercraft? Well, great news. Turns out it was just a bad oil pressure switch. So it turns out the Lincoln is okay. Who wants to hear the symphony? The 460 symphony. So I don't know if you guys could see all the exhaust smoke and steam stuff coming out from here, but that's incredibly bad. When you have exhaust leaking like that in the body areas, that actually will rust your body from the inside out. So I'm gonna have to do something about the mufflers as well. Still though, I'm ecstatic that the engine is good to go. Oh, on that note, now I'm gonna wrap this episode up and we're gonna get back to work on our 89 Ram Charger, which is progressing nicely. I'm actually waiting for paint to dry on that right now, on the cooling fan for it. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the episode. I love making it. I'll catch up with you guys next time. Bye.